Very recently, a friend pointed out something to me that really caught my attention. He's actually been using the Nik Collection plugins from within Capture One. And I don't mean Capture One Pro, I'm talking here about the free Express edition that you can get for Fuji and also for Sony cameras. The reason it caught my attention is because I didn't think that Capture One had the ability in these free editions to use plugins, but it does. And it's really simple how you can do this. At the moment, I've got open on my screen a folder that I've imported from a recent shoot I did in Scotland. I've also created a project under the User Collections part, and within that project, I've then created an album. And within the album, I've added one of the images that I want to process. Now at the moment, this image has been adjusted using Capture One. The only problem is I'd like the blue to be a little bit bluer and more intense, and I'd also like the pink in the sky to be much more defined and stronger. Now normally, I'd make these changes using Viveza, or perhaps I would use Color Effects Pro. But because we're in Capture One, I then start having to export images, I lose track of them, and all sorts of things. I'd really like a way of launching the Nik Collection from within Capture One. At the moment, if I right click on this image, I can actually choose the option to edit with. And we've only got Adobe Photoshop together with the preview option in the Mac. Now, although I've got an other, all it does is open up the browser window in the folder I'm in. So I'm just going to cancel that. The way to add the Nik Collection is using the preferences. So if I go to the Capture One preferences, what we've got is this plugin tab. I've never noticed it before. And if I scroll down, you can see what we've got in here are all the applications that I've got on my Mac that I can then pick from, including Viveza. And we've also got in here, we should have Color Effects Pro. There we are. And I've other tools as well, such as the Luminar editions or editors. And I've also got in here Affinity Photo. So there's lots of options here. I'm just going to close that now. And straight away, I've now got those applications available for editing this image. All I have to do is right click. And now, if I look at Edit With, I've got the option of the Color Effects Pro and also Viveza. So let's just load up Viveza and we'll see how this works. So the first thing you should realize is here, what we've got is the export option where we can export the image in a different format. And you can see here that we're going to export to Viveza 2. I can choose to export a JPEG or a TIFF. I'm going to take TIFF and I'm going to use the 16-bit option. I'm also going to make sure that I export as uncompressed because it's not usually a good idea to compress the 16-bit TIFFs. It tends to blow the size up. And I'm also going to use the ICC profile of Adobe RGB. We'll leave the rest of the options here and I'll just click now the Edit Variants. Now the reason you get an Edit Variants option up is because you're not editing the original RAW or RAW file. What you're doing is you're going to generate a TIFF, which is considered a variant of the original RAW file, and then you'll edit that. So we'll just click that Edit option. Now what's happening is that we're generating a new TIFF file, and then we open up that TIFF file in Viveza. So now I can start to add the options I wanted to for editing. So we'll just enhance the sky. I'm just going to hold down my Command key, which is a Control key on the PC, just to make that selection. You can see that that shows me as a mask where I'm selecting. I'm just going to warm that up very slightly. And I'm going to increase the red in that area because I want this to appear pink. I'll reduce the green. And I'll also just increase the blue in that area slightly. And that gives me the nice pink colour. And now we'll move that into position. I'll just hold down my Option key, which is the Alt key on a PC. That allows me to click and drag to duplicate the control point. So we've now made that area of the sky nice and pink. I'm probably just going to warm up the entire image a little bit with a global adjustment, and we'll just boost the saturation and just add a little bit of contrast in there. If I compare that to the original, I can see that that's made a good adjustment along the lines that I wanted. I can now save that. So Viveza is now saving the adjustment I've made back to the TIFF file, and the TIFF file has now been added to my collection. And because I used Capture One to generate the TIFF file, it's also added it back into my original folder where all my other images are saved. So if you want to use plugins, just go to the Preferences option, take the Plugins tab, and then you can add in the plugins that you want to use, and they integrate very nicely. I hope you found that useful. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.